Hello everyone, welcome to Dennis Simplified. Today, we are going to learn how to swap the values of two variables in C++. We will first create a reference to visualize our algorithm, and then model our algorithm in writing our C++ code. So, let's simplify. Devise a computer solution that interchanges the values of two variables x and y. The original values of x and y will be entered via the keyboard. Test the solution with initial values of x and y being 10 and 20 respectively. At the end of the test, do you have x and y to be 20 and 10 respectively? If yes, then your computer solution may be correct. Ideally, when you want to swap the contents of two different containers, you may want to have a third container, which will hold the contents of container 1 and container 2 temporarily at some point. With this, we can introduce a third variable called a temporary variable, temp in this case. The x variable holds 10, y holds 20, and temp is currently empty. Since temp is currently empty, we assign to temp the value of x, which is 10. Now, x is empty. The y variable holds 20 and temp holds 10. Since x is empty, we assign to x the value of y, which is 20. Now the x variable is 20, y is empty, and temp holds 10. Since y is empty, we assign to y the value of temp. Now x is 20, y holds 10, and temp is empty. The initial values of x and y were 10 and 20, respectively, and the final values of x and y are 20 and 10, respectively. With this concept in mind, we can write the algorithm. So first, we ask the user to input the values of x and y. So we say input x and y. Next, we assign temp the value of x. We assign temp the value of x. So we say temp equals x. Then next, we assign x the value of y. So we say x equals y. Then next, we assign y the value of temp. So we say y equals temp. Now we would like to display the current values of x and y. So we say print x and print y. Alright guys, we are through with our algorithm. Now let's see how we will model our algorithm in C++. But before that, pause the video, take a moment to like this video and subscribe. Very well. Now to our code in C++. In our int main function, we declare x, y, and temp to hold integer values. Then we ask the computer to display s column. Now, to see how x colon in quotation marks, meaning x colon here is a string. Then next, we ask the user to input the integer value of x. After that, we ask the computer to display y colon. And then, seeing y, the user should input the integer value of y. Now, with the x and y values, from the user, we say temp equals x, x equals y, and y equals temp. This code here will ensure the swap. Now we say cout end line. That is, we want the computer to move to a fresh line or a new line. Then we say cout x colon in quotation marks, x and then end line. So the computer should display x colon, attach the integer value of x, and then move to the next line. Then on the next line, it should display y colon, attach the y value to the y, and then end line. Now we have system port is greater than zero. This system port is greater than zero will ensure that only the needed information will be displayed when we run our code. Then per custom, we return zero. So now let's input some values for x and y and see how our code will run. So as a user myself, my x value was 10, my y value was 20. And then when I run my code, I have x to be 20 and y to be 10. So you can see the swap of the values here. All right, so you can see our code is running properly. One thing I would like to add is that this is not the only approach of solving this problem. There's actually another way of solving this in which there is no introduction of a temporary variable. But let's leave that for another day. All right, guys. Show some love by liking and subscribing to my YouTube channel. My name is Dennis. See you in the next video. Till then, I'll pass ya.